Hello, everyone. Hi. Can you all at least say hi? Raise your hand, everyone. Yes. Hi. Do you all remember me? Huh? Yes. So hi, everyone. Good afternoon. This is Professor Vinita. We have met before, and you're going to meet me a number of times between today and tomorrow. So we are about to begin with the opening of this fantastic inauguration ceremony. We are going to be lighting a lamp. We have Dean Rakesh Mediratta here. We have Shashmita ma'am, and of course, the much familiar faculty to you all, Professor Raj. We are about to light the lamp to mark a very, very auspicious beginning of this wonderful journey for you. Yes? Okay. Yes. Yes. Right. Come. Okay, so did you all get to see? Were you all able to see the lighting of the lamp, everyone? Okay, can you all nod? Okay. I see lots of nodding heads. Good. So this is for you, right? It's this fantastic journey, and this is it. This was an auspicious timing. And so Dean Sir would like to speak to you all and would just like to say hi to everyone.
All right, so you'll have to pardon me. So first of all, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. You'll have to pardon me. I'm not taking out my mask now. I will do it, but not now because there's so many people around and we are slightly, you know, I'm just slightly cautious. So please bear with me. I'm not taking off my mask now. See, you might be wondering what kind of a program this is because we are just lighting the lamp and then afterwards, Professor Sashmita is going to just tell you that we will log in again. So in the first place, why have you then come and asked us to join so early? Is that right?
Right, absolutely.
Yeah, so that's what. But let me tell you why we are doing it, because this is a very auspicious occasion for us, right? And this being a very auspicious occasion, and we would want to really welcome you. Suddenly something that came up said that we must at least do some kind of a symbolic starting of the program because it is a very auspicious time when you do. So I'm being very frank with you. So I didn't want to miss that auspicious time when we could connect with you because you guys are extremely important for us and this is a very, very important occasion for us. So looking at that, why don't you just join us? You can also. So therefore, looking at that, Vinita Madam will announce what we're going to do now. So don't be under any, doubt that why we were doing it. This is specifically, like I said, you guys are important and this is an important occasion for us. And we wanted to make sure that it happened in the most auspicious time. Yeah, so that's the only reason. Madam, all yours, sorry, I just came in, yeah.
Okay, so that's, sorry. Okay, so I'm taking off my mask since there's no one else around. So that's it, guys. I mean, we will meet again at 2:30. So my suggestion is have a nice, good lunch. And we'll see you very soon. Okay, so 2:30 onwards, you will hear, you know, the stalwarts in education speaking to you and giving you the most fantastic words of wisdom. So eat up your lunch so that you can pay full attention And, you know, we promise an exciting afternoon ahead. Okay. So log back in again by 2:15, 2:20. Do come back again. Okay. See you. I like the costumes. Okay, just reminding you all that ice breaking is tomorrow and not today. I hope things are not. Huh? Hope you guys are not confused. No. But I like that. I like Satyam's bows. Yeah. Just for a little bit. For a little while we can, yeah? Yeah. So guys, we've unmuted you all. Huh? You all want to just say something to anyone in your batch? You can. Till we begin. It hasn't been done as yet. We're just waiting for our IT person to come in, and we may just unmute you all for a little bit. So I can see that everyone's all smiling. Everyone knows everyone, huh? So much for ice breaking tomorrow, guys. But how nice. So all of you all have formed your buddy groups. All of that is happening. Yeah. Okay, good. So how are the buddies treating you? I hope they're being extremely helpful. Yes. I can see Jayant laughing. Jayant, what are you laughing about? Huh? He's in splits. I'm going to unmute you in a bit. We want to hear the joke. Pradeep, can we unmute them for a little bit? Just a little bit. Can we unmute?
What are you asking?
Unmuted? Unmuted? Yeah? Yes. Okay, so you guys are all unmuted. Come on, can I just hear a couple of voices?
Hello, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
What are you testing?
I guess he's testing his own voice.
He's testing his own voice.
Who was that?
Come on, girl. Yeah. Say something.
Aparna, come on. Say something.
Who's the... Okay. Chalo, who's the comedian of the group? Come on.
Suhas Kare.
Nikita. Who?
Abhishek Zebulan.
Abhishek. Where are you, Abhishek? Abhishek, come on. Crack a joke.
Yeah.
Abhishek is not funny. He's scary.
Shoaib, it's Abhishek, right?
Yeah, ma'am. Absolutely.
That unanimous that he's the funniest guy in the batch.
Masoom is the funniest.
Masoom is best, actually.
Yes, ma'am. Masoom
again. Masoom is best when it comes to comedy. Masoom is
best. Masoom. Okay.
He's the best.
Let's hear it from Masoom.
He's not at all funny.
Yes, ma'am.
Where are they? I don't hear them.
Here I am.
Shoaib himself sounds quite entertaining. Shoaib, come on.
Shoaib is very entertaining.
She's famous.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes. I'm famous. I'm not entertaining.
Hi, Anand. Can you hear us?
Hey, Benny. Hi, how are you doing? Nice to see you all. Yes. And as usual, you can never get over this
That's Anand, everyone. Meet Professor Anand. He will mesmerize you into the land of the brands.
They know me. They know
and
me.
And he's a real fun person.
Some of them have attended
we
one.
We met him, ma'am.
Oh, they've already attended.
One yes, we pre-foundation.
We have attended his already.
Career in marketing.
Some of you had attended. I remember seeing some of you in that lecture. So good, yeah. Welcome to Jaxom. Very nice to see you guys. I just wish we would have been on campus. It would have
that
been
would
much,
have
more
much
fun.
More
we
fun,
wish for yes. the same, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
but inshallah, very soon, I think, hopefully, everything going well, everybody getting vaccinated, we should be back. I'm hoping that when your first term starts, which I guess would be end of August, right? So you should be back in campus, hopefully, everything going well.
Okay, guys, just a request on chat. If you all have taken your vaccination, can you all just say yes, first dose? Okay. If you have, just say yes. Wow. We'll see. Oh my goodness, everyone, literally. Superb.
Everyone is so excited to come back to the campus. So yes, we are very fast on taking the vaccine.
Yes, yes.
We just want offline classes.
Absolutely. No, unless you guys come here, then only the fun will start. Okay.
I'm done with both my doors.
You're done with both. Wow.
I'll be the first one to join.
Wow. That's like practically everyone. Yeah.
Only one dose.
Okay, we are going to begin in just a little bit. Yeah. So we've muted. He was here just. They've already seen and heard enough of me by now. Lots of you. Shall I start?
Yes, ma'am.
Start? Okay. Okay, so guys, we are about to begin. So good afternoon, batch of PGDM 21-23. A very, very good afternoon to all of you all. And it was really nice to have that little, you know, window of actually communicating with you. But of course, lots ahead. So good afternoon, batch of PGDM 21-23, our esteemed dignitaries, the JAXOM leadership team, deans, program chair, faculty, staff, and parents. On behalf of the Jagdish Sheth School of Management, I, Professor Binita Vartak, take this opportunity to welcome you all to JAXOM and to the inaugural function for the 27th batch of PGDM students. A very, very special welcome to Rakshit. So we have one of your friends who's here with us. So a very special welcome to Rakshit Shrujan of the 21-23 batch, who has joined us today in live and in person. This is really exciting. Rakshit, why don't you just come and say hi? Come, Rakshit. Say hi to your friends.
Hi, guys. Hello, everyone.
Come on, can we see a wave?
Okay.
Say something. Hi, how are you all?
I mean, I really feel you guys are missing out on a lot. You should have been here. It's really good. The experience, I'm sure it'll be wonderful.
Thank you, Rakshit. So thank you so much, Rakshit. I mean, you coming here, your presence here means really a lot to us, and I'm sure even more so to your batchmates. So these are, of course, Rakshit, your new friends, and you know, we'll soon be friends. So Batch, your journey into tomorrow and its beyond begins with us here and today. Your co-travelers in this journey are us, your faculty, staff, the JAXCOM leadership team, and of course, your seniors. This magical journey through JAXCOM with its experiential and integrated learning style will nurture you to become holistic, socially responsible, and of course, continuously employable professionals. We stand strong and true to our mission, and this is our commitment to you, to help you prepare for the calling of the industry, to fulfill your aspirations, and of course, meet with tremendous success. So we would now like to welcome you into our world of knowledge with the Deeksha Aram ceremony. May I now request Rakshit to join us for this ceremony, and of course, our faculty too. Rakshit will represent your batch, and we, the faculty, would like to bestow all of you with our blessings so that our minds become one. Yeah, so this is a small customary tradition that we do with every batch. And of course, if you were here in person, you would have been holding a diya. Right, an unlit diya, and we as faculty would have lit diyas, and as you sort of, you know, as you would be walking up the steps towards the auditorium, you would be lighting your diya from us. Okay, so that's the tradition, and we are trying to replicate it. Okay, so that was a beautiful moment. You know, like I said, if we were here in person, you would have done it in person, but you know, the intention, of course, is there. So, you know, it's all about, you know, uniting your minds with us. And, you know, that was, you know, the thought behind this entire little ceremony. So we will now move ahead. We will now move ahead with the lighting of the lamp. So before we move ahead with the inauguration function, I would like to request our esteemed dignitaries to kindly light the ceremonial lamp, which is, of course, symbolic of the illustrious future that lies ahead for our new friends. May I now request Mr. Sanjay Patode, co-founder of Jagdish Sheth School of Management and president of Vijay Bhumi University, Dr. Atish Chattopadhyay, the director at JAXCOM, Mrs. Kalpana Patode, Secretary CDE, Mr. Rakesh Mediratta, Dean Academics and International Partnerships here at JAXCOM, and of course, our new friend Rakshit, to please come forward to light the lamp to mark an auspicious beginning. Play the audio. Bidisha, your senior from the 22-22 batch, will invoke the blessings of the Almighty through her divine voice. Congratulations, batch, and thank you so much, everyone. And we are now off to an auspicious and a really, really good start. So, batch, I'm sure you're aware that JAXCOM, formerly known as the IFM Business School, has completed 25 years in the education space, and we've absolutely created a hallmark for ourselves. The 25 years legacy has been a memorable journey with milestones achieved, lessons learned, and most importantly, powerful impact done. With our global QS Masters ranking, cutting-edge bespoke curriculum to create T-shaped professionals, AAACSP accreditation under our belt, award-winning practice programs and strong industry connections, and of course, a dynamic faculty body. We are now ahead by 25 years and of course, all set to take you beyond tomorrow. Let me share the 25 years journey with you through a visual representation. So I'm sure you enjoyed that video. So from a fledgling to an absolute contender in the global arena, and you're going to be a part of that. So aren't you guys lucky, right? Okay, so we're going to move on. Batch of 2021, you will now meet our dashing and dynamic co-founder of Jaxom, a visionary, Mr. Sanjay Patode. We are what we are today only because of his foresight. A graduate from the Birla Institute of Technology and Science, Mr. Patode founded Dataline and Research Technologies Limited. This company was the first in the country to pioneer the concept of online access to financial information and a nationwide online service, India Online, which was the Indian avatar of the internet before the same was, of course, launched by BSNL. The company also partnered with Dow Jones Telerate to establish their online news and ticket delivery platform in the country, the first, believe me. After serving 22 years in financial technologies and information technology, Mr. Patode chose to dedicate himself to the cause of education. Sanjay Patode founded India's first liberal professional university, Vijay Bhumi University at Karjat in the Greater Mumbai region. You guys are going to hear more about this magical university in a bit. Sir, may I now invite you to share your welcome to this fantastic new batch.
A very good afternoon to the new batch, the 26th batch, and 26th batch of probably the IFM Business School legacy and the first batch of Jagdish Seth School of Management. So you guys are privileged because you guys are the first batch which will begin with the name Jagdish School of Management and probably end your tenure and your degree with Jagdish Seth School of Management. A very, very warm welcome to all of you. So I'm going to take a few minutes to speak about what you're in for while making a choice to come to Jagdish Seth School of Management. But before that, I would like to actually talk to you about what does the IFIM group of institutions or the IFIM spirit really stand for. So the IFIM spirit is easily spelled. You know, it's an abbreviation. It's basically spelled as Inspired Family Igniting Minds. So it's about what you just went through right now was Diksha Aram. I wish you would have experienced this in reality. Diksha Aram is the, you know, it's the initiation of your journey with all the faculties to jointly start learning. It's not about a teaching and learning. The whole teaching and learning is two ways. It's not one way. At least at IFM Business School, now Jagdish Seth School of Management. The whole philosophy is about with every graduating batch, our teachers also graduate. They graduate with more knowledge. And with every incoming batch, we are looking forward to new learnings from the students. While we continue to impart what we have learned, while we continue to create knowledge, while we are continuously publishing, we are working with corporates and a lot of things, you will experience a lot of that at Jagdish Seth School of Management. Let me tell you, one thing which I can make a tall claim for, A, you will be working with the best in class faculty. There won't be a compromise in an iota of compromise in the kind of delivery you'll experience from this faculty. B, it's not just the amount of knowledge or the pedigree of each faculty that matters. What matters more at Jaxom is the commitment and the conviction that the faculty brings to the table. You will experience that too. And I think you guys are going to be very privileged. The amount of work this faculty puts in behind each student is amazing. So when I came into education after quitting from my entrepreneurial journey as a fintech entrepreneur, in those times, there was nothing called fintech. It was purely an IT company operating in the domain of finance. But today, you know, it's more commonly known as fintech. When I came here, I came with only one aspiration. I mean, one objective, and that is to liberalize education. And what do I mean by liberalized education is, if you look at it, what is liberalization? Liberalization is getting out of the clutches of people, getting out of the clutches of thought of people who think who are educators or people who think who run that particular domain. Let's put it like this. So my main objective was to liberate each student and make the student the choice maker of what and how the student wants to learn. And that's what I meant by liberalizing education. I'm not talking about liberal thought. I'm talking about the way education is delivered. So what I wanted to do was liberate the student from the diktat of the educators. In the sense, you would have experienced in your probably 16 years or 15 years of education in the past, your syllabus was frozen. How you gave your exam was frozen. What kind of projects you did was frozen. The way you wrote your answers was also frozen. It was not important only to get the answer right. It was also important to how you came to that answer, which was important. The constraint that you had was you could never exercise your imagination. You could never exercise the inherent innovation that exists within each human being. And this is what I started with, a simple objective. I was not sure, because this was a tough call, because, you know, the legacy of teaching, the legacy of faculty is huge. I think teaching probably is the oldest profession in the world. So considering wanting to make a change in that profession was a very, very, difficult thought that I had at the point of time I joined. But thanks to the faculty, let me tell you, you're going to be working with probably the best faculty who's most committed. And my advice to you is be open, take every opportunity to engage with them, get the best out of them. I'm not telling you they'll have all the right answers all the time. But one thing I can assure you, each one of them is going to make the best effort to get you the right answer that you are seeking. So get your questions out, be inquisitive, be interactive in class, and go for it. That's what you are here for. Okay. The second thing I want to talk to you is this myth about getting to a business school to get a job. So I'm going to basically make the statement that we are not a job placement agency. And a mission very clearly says that we need to nurture holistic, socially responsible, and continuously employable professionals. So we have a more difficult task than just getting you your first job. Our task is to ensure that you're employable continuously for life. That means you should never be insecure that you're ever going to be without a job or without work at hand. So that is the task, and that is the mission of each faculty. So get rid of that myth as well. What's going to get you your job and what's going to get you your career are the choices you're going to make during the next 2 years. The choices of courses, the choice of learning, how you're going to learn, because this institution will provide you all the choices that, you know, that are there in terms of learning, whether it's online learning, blended learning, face-to-face learning, immersive learning, experiential learning, internships, all that is packaged into your curriculum. So the curriculum design the curriculum architecture is being done not by ourselves. It's not a whims and fancy of a couple of educators who said that, you know, I've been teaching for the last 50 years, so I know what has to be taught, and I'm just going to vomit out my experience and say, this is what students have got to learn. No, that's not how our curriculum got designed. Our curriculum actually got designed first by learning from our experience of what we were teaching here. That means getting feedback from alumni, getting feedback from students. Second, going to the industry and asking what is it that they need. Third, referring to the researches created by organizations like World Economic Forum, National Human Resource Development Network, which basically captured where is the gap. And putting all this together and curating an architecture of learning, which is what our curriculum is. Our curriculum is very different from a syllabi. It's not about just courses. It's about the overall experience that each one of you is going to get while at the institution. And that is what this curriculum 4.0 is all about. And let me tell you that innovative curriculum is not something which has just got doctored in this small institution. It's a curriculum that has been accepted by the gold standard of accreditation, which is AACSB. It's a curriculum which Professor Jagdish Sheth, who's the chairman of this particular business school, who has actually lent his name, has adopted. And you look at the governing board members that we have. We have Professor Tan from Singapore Management University. We have professors from Georgia State University. We have professors from ESCP Europe. We have industrialists, the co-founder of HCL. We have the founder of one of the most successful venture funds, IDG Ventures, and now Chirate. You have one of the managing directors of the largest publishing company in India, Wiley. With all of those guys have given their blessings to this curriculum. So this curriculum is about experience. And the only way you can experience it is if you trust it and you immerse yourself in it. So two advices to you, okay, from my end. One is get the maximum from faculty. And second, immerse yourself into that curriculum. There will be certain things you may not like, and there will be some things that you love, but the curriculum will definitely balance it out and give you an outcome which will help your individual personality emerge the way it should be. So the whole objective of this curriculum is not to make you into a Sundar Pichai. It is to make you into a successful Rakshit or a successful Harish or a successful Rahul. That is what this curriculum is all about. You are going to be the person who others will vie for. It's not going to be aping somebody. It's about letting yourself be performing at your best level. So that's what the curriculum is all about. This Diksharam is about giving yourself into that experience and going through that journey. This journey will help you explore your purpose. This journey will align your purpose to your curriculum. This journey will give you those learning experiences required for you to make yourself ready for that purpose and be successful in your purpose. So that is the whole architecture of the curriculum. I think with this, I would just like to again tell you all the best. We are a very, very value-centric institution. We believe in a value, and our values are best spelt in the word guru. So it's about genuine transparency. It is relentless pursuit for perfection, unity through belonging, and unstoppable dynamism. Those are the four tenets. So it's G-U-R-U, which basically spells as guru. And those are that's the value system that we all believe in. When you come to this campus, which hopefully will be opening on August 14th, not hopefully, last year also, I think we were the only business school that had face-to-face classes in spite of all the kind of lockdowns. We engineered our way around, and not that we defied the authorities. We ensured we took all the precautions to have our students in a safe environment in the most safe way and delivered face-to-face classes. They did internships. They went through the immersions. We did not miss a single intervention of our business school, and that's hats off to your faculty, because they put in a lot, they risked a lot, but they made it all happen. So with that, welcome and thank you very much, and all the best.
Okay. So what words of inspiration? I think I feel like becoming a student again and joining JAXOM and living this journey. I can, of course. You know, I think one thing that is absolutely magnificent about JAXOM, and what I truly love, is that the management here is accessible to us, of course, 24 hours, but they're also accessible to you. You know, there's no closed doors. You can just walk into Sanjay sir's room and Atish sir's room and just, you know, pour your heart out. And I think that's what we all love about JAXOM. Okay, so let me just now go ahead. Now, Dr. Atish Chattopadhyay, a director, would now like to heartily welcome you to JAXOM and to a journey of enlightenment. An entrepreneur and an educator, Dr. Atish Chattopadhyay is a keen proponent of globalization of Indian business schools. He has previously held leadership positions at top institutions like SPJIMR, Mumbai, MICA, Ahmedabad, and IMT, Ghaziabad. Under his leadership, schools have initiated pioneering pedagogical innovations which have won accolades globally, including the coveted WCSB's Innovations That Inspire Award. As a professor of marketing, Dr. Atish has published in top journals and consulted with top MNCs covering the Asia Pacific and Latin America. So Dr. Atish, the floor is yours. He's a true entrepreneur by mind, and I think you guys are going to learn tremendous things from Dr. Atish. And of course, everywhere he goes, we just win awards, right? Dr. Atish, yeah.
So thank you, Binita Madam, and it's great to be here, first of all, and a very good afternoon to each one of you, to our co-founder and president, Vijayabhumi University, Sanjay Padode, Srimati Kalpana Padode, my friends in the faculty and administration, my staff members, the alumni who are here, and my dear students. First of all, hearty congratulations for being the first batch, as you said, of JAXOM. And I think all of you deserve a round of applause. You know, you have to do the applause means you have to go to the reaction, choose the applause button and do it. Because we are now there, okay? And you have to learn quickly, okay? Yeah, that's the way, you got it. Yeah, that's it, okay? Okay, now because you know that there are my faculty is also here, and as Sanjay was saying, that we were actually one of the few institutions which were on campus, and I've been teaching all through. Okay, even today morning I taught, correct? So I would like to interact with you in a way where you know it can be a dialogue type. Okay, so I think first of all, as I said, you deserve a congratulations. But your parents also deserve a congratulations. So one more round of applause for your parents. So congratulations to you, your parents, my faculty, my staff members, and the entire JAXOM family, and a hearty welcome to the JAXOM family. I would give you a little bit of, you know, introduction about Jagdish Sheth School of Management and JAXOM. I thought of reading out the written down speech. Normally that happens, but I thought that, okay, let me have an interactive, you know, kind of a discussion where I can go free flow, okay? And I was just thinking, when you said this 26th, you know, batch of JAXOM and IFIM, so to say, I was just counting back, okay? And I was counting back and thinking, this is my 13th, commencement address. And I already done 12 convocation addresses, okay. So it's a fantastic thing. And then I was wondering, and one of the things that you mentioned suddenly in between was, and a small institution, and that stuck me. And then I decided not to read out this written down speech, okay. That's how it happened. See, I was just immediately reminded back, and you know, Binita Madam gave a very strong introduction of mine, okay? And he talked about me in leadership position at SPJIMR Mumbai, at MICA Ahmedabad, and then at IMT Ghaziabad. Okay, all three institutions I was there, but you missed out IBS or ICFI Business School. So I have been in smaller institutions earlier. If you go back, I was one of the earliest faculty members to join IBS. For some of you, it is now a big institution and 100-acre campus, but you won't believe that in the 90s, when we started off, we were in a rented premises where the ground and the first floor were the classes. And from the second floor, the cloth of the landlady used to hang. That was IBS of late 90s. Okay. And if I look back at the graduates today, and I was telling you this, if I look back at the graduates who graduated before 2000, so up to 2000, you know, what is that batch called? The .com, what do you call that? The millennium batch, okay, where there was this huge issue, okay. If I look back at the batches that time, they're extremely, extremely successful. If I land up in Singapore, there are people to receive me who are the alumnus. In Hong Kong, yes. In US, yes. And if I today, you know, you will get the announcement very shortly. Some of you probably are regretting that you did not get into that institution and hence came to JAXOM. But the director of one of the premium institutions will be, and you will get the announcement shortly, was a pass out of a batch of 2000 of IBS. Okay, who is today heading, is going to head a premier institution. What does that imply? It implies what Sanjay said just now. If there's a faculty effort and there is a student effort, and if both joins hand together, then you can make it happen. It doesn't matter from where you are and who you are. Provided you are interested and you have the best faculty. And Sanjay is absolutely dot on, okay? When he says that our faculty is probably one of the best in the country. And of course, the curriculum. Because you know, what made that happen, those who graduated in 2000, is because of the kind of faculty we had and the kind of curriculum that was there. If I look back at SPJMR, okay, you know, you will be surprised. And I'm talking about, you know, when this 2000 batch, I remember there were hardly 60 odd students in IBS. And if I look back, you will be surprised that when I joined SPJMR, the graduating batch, I remember of 2008, there were only 90 students. Okay? And today it's in a different league. Now, you must be wondering then why this guy left IBS at that time, the year it was moving into the 100-acre campus. Why this guy left, you know, SPJMR the year it got into the top 5 ranking. Now, we have this pedigree of the heritage because we are founded, our founder was the founder of Dalal Street Investment Journal. That's Sanjay's father, late V.B. Parode. And you all know that's the, that's the Wall Street Journal version of India, Dalal Street Investment Journal. And you know, Dalal Street is the, where the stock market is located, and those who are in finance and those who are today, tracking it, today it is at the highest ever level. Okay, so we are starting on the right time, on the right day. Okay, the stock market is at its peak. Okay, and hence that also shows that we can be bullish about the economy and we can be bullish about you. Now, what it makes for someone to be successful in stock market? What it takes essentially is that you bet on the right stock, okay? And when it has not become an Infosys, if you invest in Infosys today, there is no return. But you would have invested in 90s, then there is a return. So you have to identify which stock you should invest in. Okay, and that's not just about stock, it is about your career as a student, everywhere you need to identify which is the stock which is going to be the winner. So I betted and you go back in 2006, 7, you will see that IBS was in the top 10 in the Business Today ranking. And it was moving into the 100-acre campus, I left that time. Okay, 2009, you will not believe, when I became the program chair at SPJMR, it was 19th rank in Business Today. And I left when it was in fourth rank. Okay, now we'll be wondering, you're pagal hai kya? Question is, whether you are an investor in the stock market, whether you are a faculty or a professional who is looking for a career or as a student, You have to choose the right stock which is going to be the winner going forward. And I congratulate you for choosing the right stock. Okay. This is an institution which is going to be the winner. Okay. And I can bet my money on it. Okay. So I would say that you wait for another. We are already there. Okay. You have not participated in the ranking for the last 2 years in the Indian ranking. Okay. But if I go and do an objective assessment of, because I've seen all the top institutions, their faculty, their curriculum. If I do an objective assessment of institutions across the country, and someone asks me, where do you like to bet your money on? It will be Jaxom. And you would have been my son, you are my son's age, and if somebody would have asked me, and a lot of people ask this question, okay, where that one should take an admission. If you get into some 8 institutions, I am naming them, A, B, C, XLRI, SPGMR, MDI, I am Indore, I am Kozhikode, FMS. If you have got into these 9 institutions, I would say take the admission. Okay? If it is anything excepting 9, I would bet my money on Jaxom in today. So I don't think you should have any regret for joining Jaxom. Okay? By the time you graduate, you will see the whole situation has changed. Okay? Reason being that what Sanjay said, the curriculum and the pedagogy and the faculty will make you what our mission stands for, continuously employable. Everybody thinks of the first job, but first job is never the last job. Correct? What happens to you after 20 years of your graduation is what matters. It doesn't matter where you start from. And I just gave you the example of that graduating batch of 2000 of IBS. Today, they are making the waves. If you compare your peers who probably got into institutions which are today better ranked after 15 years, and you compare where you are vis-a-vis your peers who joined so-called ranked and named institution, I can bet 15 years hence, you will be better off than your peers. Okay? So start taking pride in your institution, in yourself, and be confident that you can make it happen. And if you believe that you can make it happen, I can assure you that you will 100% make it happen. I always say, I teach marketing, and I keep on saying the same thing, that if you have attended my classes, you can be better marketeer than anybody else in the country. That's guaranteed. Okay, and that's true for our finance professors, and that's true for my, you know, professors in analytics or digital business or in HR. You go through the faculty profile, you go through the curriculum, you will know that you can beat your peers hands down. On an apple-to-apple comparison, there's no chance. Now, given this background, because a lot of times, you know, it happens. You know, okay, I was aiming for so-and-so institution. This was my top of the order. I did not get in. Some kind of feeling happens. What in marketing we say cognitive dissonance. Okay, some dissonance. Wo shaadi karne ke baad itna aadmi ko kyun bulata hai? For after getting married, okay, you are getting married in any case, and somebody, you will also get married someday. Okay, why do you call those 500 people around? You know why? Because to the bride, everybody will come and say, you have got chosen the right guy. And to the guy, everybody will say that you have chosen the right bride. It is like this. So one of the things that I wanted to tell you is that you have made the right choice. Okay. And be confident of the fact that you can do things which others cannot do. Okay. Now, of course, there will be a lot of deliberations. As you saw, I say, I made a complete deviation. As usual, you know, I become an impromptu person whenever somebody gives me a mic or a stage. Okay, and I never go, you know, I am a pure chalk and board kind of a teacher. Even during the pandemic, I remained like that only. Okay, so, and I will interact with you, don't worry. Okay, in my classes of marketing. So now let me tell you some of the key things about Jaxom. Okay. And a lot of you are not aware of certain things. And there I will tell you, you know, what makes Jaxom so special. Okay. The first thing is that if you look at India and why we decided not to participate in the rankings. Reason being that the parameters keep on changing. What happens is you think of those situations where nobody measures what is the value added to the students. Now think of the, and I'm taking the names, think of IIMs, think of SPGMR, think of MICA, the institutions that I have been to. Ye sab record mat kar raha hoon, ki kar raha hoon, Bhagwan jane. Okay. Now, but I'm telling on record only. Okay. Now the point is, if you look at these institutions for the since last March, none of the guys have ever sat in the classroom, correct? What is the value add in that case? Whatever value we have added, whatever value the other institutions have added will be the similar because you have not come to the campus only. Our students were there in campus from October to April 20. April 20 only we closed down, okay? And that's why again August 14, you people are back on campus. Now the measure of ranking is, what is the input criteria? If I take a 100 percentile, if I don't do anything, put them in Khandala for the next 2 years, still they will be good. So what is the value add? That is never get measured. Now take a situation of an institution which takes 70 percentile, 80 percentile, add so much value through the curriculum and the faculty that they become as good as 100 percentile. To me, that institution is doing a better job than an institution which has taken 100 percentile and kept them at 100 percentile. We have taken a 70 percentile and made them like an 100 percentile. What we are in our institution say, learner potential multiplier. So all our initiatives, all our interventions are to multiply your potential. And as I said, if you believe in yourself, our curriculum and faculty will make sure that your potential gets multiplied. And you, whether you are a 60 percentile or a 70 percentile, will become as good as 100 percentile, and that's my promise. If there is one promise, that's the promise that I make to you, that if whatever may be your situation today, and if you are regretting that you did not crack the cat the way somebody else cracked it, by being here, you will be becoming as good as 100 percentile, provided you put that effort. Correct? So our curriculum intervention that you see is to multiply the potential which you have in you. Agreed? Are you confident about yourself now? Are you thumbs up to the OB reaction? Mein. Correct. I don't see the thumbs up. Yeah, now I can see it. Okay. So that's the basic promise. And if you put the effort, we put the effort, we can make it happen. Now there is one promise that I want from you, that you will make it happen. And you write that in the chat, that we will make it happen. Write that. Have you written that? Quickly, the chat box is open. Yeah. Let me see their face, not just the chat. Okay, so it's a promise that we promise that we give you the best in terms of the curriculum and the faculty. Nothing can be better like having a chairman like Professor Jagdish Sheth, Professor Jagdish Sheth is not only a professor of Emory, but the highest award for a non-resident is not Bharat Ratna, but Padma Bhushan. So he's a Padma Bhushan awardee. Search for Professor Jagdish Sheth. If you look at the curriculum which Sanjay talked about, was mentored by Professor Parasuraman, who is the chairman of our board of studies. And he's the guru of service marketing. You just type Parasuraman, service marketing, you will see. And he's the highest cited researcher of the world. Okay. So he was the one who guided us for our curriculum. We have the faculty. I don't want to go one by one because that's what you will get to know tomorrow. I don't want to take the thunder out. But most importantly, if you put the effort, given our curriculum and pedagogy, you will see that you have taken that leap, which is far superior than your peers. So it's a great decision for you to join JAXOM. All the very best. Congratulations once again. And we meet. Thank you so much.
Okay, so I'm sure the fire in your belly has got ignited, hasn't it, after this extremely powerful speech? And of course, as Dr. Atish sir, you know, did tell you that together we will move mountains. Okay, that's our promise and our commitment to you. Okay, I'd now like you to meet a very, very special person. Okay, a person that you're going to be seeing quite often. A person who leads one of the most fantastic initiatives that you're all going to be play a very, very active role in. I'm sure you've read about Kanyathon, right? The student-driven marathon that all of you all are going to be a part of. So I'd like you to meet Mrs. Kalpana Patode. Okay, she's an inspiration to me for sure, if not to all of us here. And you will be seeing a lot of her. Okay, so I'd just like her to say a quick hello to you.
Last minute surprise. And it's so difficult to add something after learned people like Dr. Atish and Sanjay Patode. Nevertheless, I will keep it very short and brief. Good evening, my dear students. Welcome to JAXOM. And I'm pretty sure the dynamic faculty and the gurus, they will take good care of you academically. But apart from academics, we will ensure that your extracurricular is also taken care of. And you will see me more in those initiatives. And I will be part of that and looking forward to seeing you and meeting you in person. And wishing you all the best. Take care, be safe, and see you soon. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. And my apologies for springing this onto you at the last minute, but I just couldn't resist. Okay, so guys, guess it's now time for you to meet your super, super seniors, as I call them. Okay, they are your well-wishers and they would like to give you some inspirational advice that I'm sure will help you get noticed in the corporate for, of course, all the right reasons. They have just begun their journey and they're from the 1921 batch. You are going to meet three of my favorites, if I have to say so. Sorry, I shouldn't be saying that as faculty, but I couldn't resist. You will meet Fahadullah, you will meet Dia, and you will meet Varnika. Okay, and they're all, you know, fantastic students and they're doing fantastically in the corporate. So let me begin by calling Fahad. I mean, his name is Fahadullah, but I mean, I've been calling him Fahad. Okay, so Fahad is with Accessium as an associate. And in fact, he was also with Moody Analytics even before he joined JAXOM. He's a specialist in investment banking and in the commercial lending sector, as well as extremely experienced in analysis of potential investments and acquisitions. Fahad did his PGDM in finance and analytics with us. Fahad at JAXOM played a very strong role in a lot of interventions. He was the president of the Finance Club Alpha, which I'm sure a lot of you all are going to be part of. He was the chief information officer for Kanyathon, you know, which as I said, was our charity marathon, and an absolute whiz for technology and numbers. Okay, Fahad, over to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for this wonderful introduction. I'm really happy to be part of this event today and share my experiences with you all. I had a very holistic learning experience at IFM where I could get involved in multiple areas, as ma'am told, being part of Kanyathon as well as in ESIC committees and work with diverse people and amazing faculties who helped us grow at every step. Being in a finance domain, I did not only gain finance expertise, but also other events like Kanyathon and ESIC committees helped me understand the actual scene that goes through and shape myself to achieve a great role and career. At every step, just remember your goals and never fear to take risk. That's what JAXCOM teaches you. Just take risk at every step. I'm sure you all will flourish as good individuals and make the most of it for this 2 years of your tenure in IFIM. Thank you.
Thank you, Fahad. And it was lovely seeing you. Yeah, and we miss you. We miss all of you.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. We miss you too.
Yes. Okay, now I'd like you to meet Varnika Garg. Varnika is an associate product manager at Numly Incorporated. She did her PhD in marketing in digital business, in marketing digital business, as well as analytics with us. Varnika, marketing graduate, currently working in product management and innovation after completing her PGDM here. Varnika is super skilled in product management, product marketing, Tableau, SPSS, and absolutely great at problem solving. Varnika, of course, has the innovative bug, and she's always trying new things. She's a voracious reader and a writer, and formerly owned a blog and website and solely handled all the marketing and content for it. So do meet an eloquent speaker and a writer, amongst other things, Varnika.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the beautiful introduction. So a very warm welcome to each one of you present here today. And I congratulate you for starting your new journey with IFIM. It's great that you chose IFIM as your place to be. So being your super senior, I won't give you a very long motivational speech. Rather, I'll just share a very personal and a genuine experience of me being in IFIM. I would just like to say that IFIM is a place of opportunities. And it's up to you. It's up to you where you identify the opportunities and you take them as you go along. Once you decide to choose them, you decide to take career guidance from each faculty who's there, the management. And I'm sure, I'm glad that everybody over there will be ready to help you out. So it's really up to you, as Atisha rightly said, to identify and grab those opportunities that come your way. You have to be the one, to identify them. And talking about myself, I had a very transformational journey in IFIM because it helped me identify my strengths and weaknesses. It helped me grow and work on them. You'll get very different types of unique curriculum over here, like corporate mentorship or other types of activities, where you will keep on identifying new things about you. And the moment you identify them, you should be able to apply them as you go forward. So IFIM helped me to become a better version of myself, to gain the right skills and become industry ready. And the last thing that I would just like to say is that take all challenges and problems with a positive mindset as you go forward. Never disappointed or set back with anything. Just be positive, and I'm sure you'll all have a very fruitful journey here, and you'll enjoy your journey, your two-year journey with IFIM. Thank you.
Thank you, Varnika. I mean, like I said, an eloquent speaker with wisdom. Varnika is very, very dear to us. And we are so glad to see that she's doing so well at Numly. All the very best, Varnika. And of course, I think, tremendous opportunities here at JAXCOM. And it's all about leveraging on them. So thank you for that.
Right.
It's a very useful advice. Yeah.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay, so now I'd like you to meet our third senior like Fahad and Varnika, who want to wish you all the very best in this new journey. I'd like you to meet Dia Murli. Dia is a senior associate in content marketing at Zest Money. Dia did her marketing and analytics with us. She's also got a certification in digital marketing and communication from MICA. Now, I've had a very, very close association with Dia right from the start, from the time that she entered. She was my student. Her quiet demeanor, her soft spokenness, and of course, her profound abilities in language astounded me. And I'm sure she's found her calling in content marketing. So Dia, we'd love to hear from you.
Oh my God, thank you, ma'am. I miss you so much. But like Varnika said, I don't think I have a very well-scripted speech to give. I think what you learn here is, I'll be honest, it's very challenging. It's extremely challenging, but it's also very rewarding. And the people here make the biggest difference, whether it's faculty, staff, or the students. They become your family. They will be there at every step to sort of push you to do your best. And by the end of these 2 years, you will have realized your potential in a way that you probably might not have if you hadn't joined here. So it is going to be challenging, but it's going to be very rewarding. And I think all of you will really shine. And you have the best faculty, so you're in good hands. So good luck and welcome to JAXOM or IFM. Right.
Dia. Just feels like we're in class together, right? And you don't need a script, huh? Incidentally, Dia. Okay? You remember the script, right?
Yeah, I remember.
Okay, you do. Okay, so all the very best, Dia. And thank you all three. Thank you, Fahad. Thank you, Varnika. And thank you, Dia, for... I know it's a busy afternoon. All of you all are really immersed in your work, but you yet took the time out to share your feelings and your inspirations with the batch. And thank you so much. And we look forward to meeting you soon. Okay. So on this note, we will close for today. And I would like to assure the incoming batch that the entire JAXOM community will always be there to support, sustain, encourage, and bring out the very best in you. You're now part of this vibrant learning environment where we look forward to the fresh ideas and energy that you will now bring to the campus. Okay, I'd now like to call upon Dr. Shashmita Giri, whom I'm sure is a very, very familiar figure. She's going to tell you a little bit about what tomorrow is about. Okay, over to you, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everybody. So today is our inaugural function, and we are coming to the end of this day. We have an orientation ceremony which is planned for tomorrow. You all are expected to log in by 10:15 a.m. Post that, we'll have a welcome, which is from the JAXOM family. We'll be introducing you to both the campuses. We are lucky to have two campuses. One is at Bangalore, and the other one is at Karjat. We'll also introduce you to our distinctive faculty and team members of our staff, our support system, without whom we cannot run our program. Post that, we will give you the schedule for the foundation that I'll be speaking about. And then we'll have a lunch break for around 45 minutes. 1 p.m. sharp, we will be starting with the ice break session. I already saw many of you have put on the Avengers theme, so keep it a secret. We'll be seeing it tomorrow. Last point of thought to all of you, go back today and think what you want to do and what you want to be. And this is going to make a difference in the next 2 years. Thank you.
Okay, so guys, all set for tomorrow, right? All costumes, Avengers. We want to see all the Avengers tomorrow at ice breaking. So spend the whole night getting very creative, okay? So with this, we'll draw an end today, and I'd like everyone to rise for the national anthem.
अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय 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 प्रीत मांगे गाए जय गाथा जन गण मंगल जय हे
Okay, so everyone, you all can log out and we shall see you tomorrow morning. Okay, do log in on time tomorrow.